Blessed be God's kingdom, now and forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The sentence, Christ died for our sins, in accordance with the scriptures, and was buried and was raised on the third day, in accordance with the scriptures, and appeared to many. Let us pray. Almighty God,
to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, bless the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Hymn of praise. Glory to God in the highest,
and peace to God's people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
Prayer of the day. Most holy God, in whose presence angels serve in awe, and whose glory fills all heaven and earth, cleanse our uncleanness and transform us by your grace, so that your word spoken through us may bring many to your salvation. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading of the Holy Scripture.
The first reading this morning comes from Isaiah chapter 6. Verses 1 to 8. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting on a throne, high and lofty, and the hem of his robe filled the temple. Seraphs were in attendance above him. Each had 6 wings. With 2 they covered their faces, and with 2 they covered their feet, and with 2 they flew. And one called to another and said, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory." The pivots on the threshold shook at the voices of those who called, and the house filled with smoke. And I said, "Woe is me, I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I live among people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphs flew to me, holding a live coal that had been taken from the altar with a pair of tongs. The seraph touched my mouth with it and said, "Now that this has touched your lips, your guilt has departed and your sin is blotted out." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? And who will go for us?" And I said, "Here am I, send me." Hear the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
This morning's psalm is Psalm 138. I will give you thanks, O Lord, with my whole heart. Even before the gods will I sing your praises.
I will bow down towards your holy temple and give thanks to your name because of your faithfulness and love of our kindness. For you have made your name and your words over all things.
At a time when I called to you, you gave me answer and put new strength within my soul.
All the kings of the earth shall praise.
with my life. You will stretch out your hand against the fury of my enemies, and your right hand shall save me.
The Lord will complete his purpose for me. Your loving kindness, O Lord, will endure forever. Do not forsake the work of your right hand.
Reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Now I should remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved, if you hold firmly to the message that I proclaimed to you, unless you have come to believe in vain. For I handed on to you, as of first importance, what I in turn had received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, and that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. Then he appeared to more than 500 brothers and sisters at one time, most of whom are still alive, and some have died. Then he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to someone untimely born, he appeared also to me, for I am the least of the apostles, unfit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God I am what I am. And his grace towards me has not been in vain. On the contrary, I worked harder than any of them, though it was not I, but the grace of God that is with me. Whether then it was I or they, so we proclaim, and so you have come to believe. Hear the word of the Lord.
Once while Jesus was standing beside the the Lake of Gennesaret. The crowd was pressing in on him to hear the word of God. He saw two boats there at the shore of the lake, and the fishermen had gone out of them and were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and he asked him to put out a little way from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowd from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into the deep water and let down your nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we have worked all night long, but have caught nothing. But if you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done this, they caught so many fish that their nets were beginning to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down on Jesus' knees, saying, "Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." But he and all who were with him were amazed at the catch of the fish that they had taken. And so also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid, for from now on you will be catching people." When they had brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. For the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be pleasing and acceptable to you, our Lord and Saviour. Amen. Today, we see that each of the readings point to the way, to that moment when we become aware of the mysterious presence of God in our experience. Isaiah, faced with a major change in his responsibilities, Isaiah enters the temple to reflect on the meaning of the events of his life. In doing so, he is given a vision of God that becomes his vocation. The psalm, because God has responded to him in the past, the psalmist believes that God responds to human needs when called upon. And in the Corinthians reading, Paul points to the many people who have experienced the presence of God in the risen Christ. He ends his list with his own claim to such an experience. Then we come to the Gospel. In a moment of his working day as a fisherman, Peter becomes aware of Jesus in a new and a piercing way that is both disturbing and deeply captivating. If we can use our imagination, we can see the Sea of Galilee and the small indentations along the shore lake that were natural gathering places. The area sloped slightly towards the edge of the water. The rising ground behind provides an echo chamber for the voice. And our Lord apparently appears to speak from a slight distance. He prefers this. The few yards of water between him
and the crowd may help him carry his words more easily and more people hear. After Jesus had spoken to the crowd, we move into significant things. For some reason, Jesus suggests dropping the nets. It diminishes the episode in no way to suggest that he may have noticed a movement of fish in his position higher on above the shore. Peter points out that a whole night's fishing has produced nothing. Significance comes in the words, "Yet, if you say so." Here is trust and respect from a disciple to a master. Perhaps this is not the first time the following instructions have paid off. But this time the result is startling. So much is caught that they have to call for help. They cannot believe their eyes. Suddenly, Peter senses that there is more here than meets his eye or anyone else's eye. He becomes aware of something which has no language. His mind may have played turns with a power or a presence. Something, there is something more than human. But no neat defining language will come. So he gives an expression to his reaction in another way. He kneels in the boat, and that must have been difficult and clumsy, undignified. Then the truth comes from the depths of Peter's being. He is aware that he is in the presence of something other than his own limited and guilt-ridden humanity. "Go away from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." If we, you and I, are fortunate, we all have done this kind of kneeling. Perhaps before an act of supreme courage, a scene of great beauty, a person of immense spiritual stature, a work of supreme art. We have done this kind of kneeling in a moment when an act of worship, familiar and often repeated, has suddenly catapulted us aware into unexpected heights, sometimes leaving us quietly weeping, not knowing why. Or should we say, knowing yet not having the language to state why. One is aware only of God's presence before whom there is nothing to do but to bow down, knowing that every conceivable aspect of one's being is transparent to God and is being judged by God. Yet that even the judgment will be loving. At such moments, there is an awareness of a vast plenitude in the soul, plenitude that Peter's eyes saw in the silver leaping of the fish, yet his whole being recognized as something more than fish. There's a beautiful gay saying that says, "By the Christ of the sea, may we be caught in the nets of God." May the Christ of the sea, by the Christ of the sea, I should say, may the Christ of the sea, may we be brought into the nets of God. It's a beautiful image. Let us pray that we will be caught in the nets of God. Amen. at them. We believe in one God,
the Father the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Let us pray for the world and for the church.
Ever-living God, help us to serve you faithfully and patiently, watching for you to be revealed in our lives. Gracious God, thank you that you call some of us to be apostles, sent out to do your work. We pray for all who respond, "Here I am, Lord," when they hear you call. We pray also for those who have a ministry in their daily lives of work, family life, or community, who daily bear witness to the gospel in all that they say or do. Lord, in your mercy,
amen.
Creator God, thank you for our world and the places where we live. Help us all to be mindful that we are all created equal in your sight, and accept our deep regret that despite this, there is still so much inequality to be found. Help us to remember that you want us to be good stewards of your future growth, be sustainable, and living responsibly in the lands and seas of the earth. And may we ensure that its abundance is fairly shared for all, and for the good for all. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Father God, help us to use our influence within our families and communities to bring peace, joy, and fun into people's lives. Help us to be reliable and honest in what we do, and friendly to all who we meet in our daily lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Loving God, friend of those in need, your Son Jesus. Jesus can free us from our burdens and heal our bodies and spirits. We pray for those still burdened, those seeking healing, those in need within the church and the world, especially those who have asked for our prayers and others known to us. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Merciful God, when death separates us from whom we love, and we find it hard to live without them, take from us all bitterness and resentment, and help us to remember that the love we share with our departed loved ones goes beyond the grave. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Eternal God, in the weeks ahead, help us to conduct our lives in the way of Jesus, and help us to bring people into the fellowship of your church. Almighty God, you have promised to hear our prayers.
Grant that what we ask in faith, we may by your grace receive. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy, welcoming sinners and inviting them to the Lord's table. Let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, confident in God's forgiveness.
Merciful God, our Maker and our Judge, we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, and in what we have failed to do. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbours as ourselves. We repent and are sorry for all our sins. Father, forgive us. Strengthen us to love and obey you in Jesus' name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Almighty God, who has promised forgiveness to all who turn to him in faith, pardon you and set you free from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in eternal life, through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us stand, reading the text. We are the body of Christ.
His Spirit is with us.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
This is James and Simon.
Sorry.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through your goodness, we have these gifts to share. Accept and use our offering for your glory and for the service of the kingdom.
Blessed be God forever.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We give thanks to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and our
praise. All glory and honor be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God. We give you thanks and praise for our Saviour, Jesus Christ, who by the power of your Spirit was born of Mary and lived as one of us. By his death on the cross and rising to new life, he offered the one true sacrifice for sin and obtained an eternal deliverance for his people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, Hosanna in the highest.
Merciful God, we thank you for these gifts of your creation, this bread and wine. And we pray that by your word and Holy Spirit, we who eat and drink them may be partakers of Christ's body and blood. On the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and when he had given you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup, and again giving you thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, shed for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Therefore we do as our Saviour has commanded, proclaiming his offering of himself made once for all upon the cross, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. And looking for his coming again, we celebrate with this bread and this cup his one perfect and sufficient sacrifice for the sins of the whole world. Let us together proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Renew us by your Holy Spirit. Unite us in the body of your Son and bring us with all your people into the joy of your eternal kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, with whom and in whom, in the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father, in songs of never-ending praise. As our Saviour Christ has taught us, we are confident to pray. God for the people of God. Come, let us take this holy sacrament of the body and blood of Christ in remembrance that he died for us and feed on him in our hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Come to the Feast of Love.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Living God, in this holy meal, you fill us with new hope. May the power of your love, which we have known in word and sacrament, continue your saving work among us. Give us courage for our pilgrimage and bring us to the joys you promise. And together we pray, Father, we offer ourselves to you as a living sacrifice
through Jesus Christ our Lord. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to lead and work to your praise and glory.
Those who love and care for you this day. Amen.